And number 10, the domain is all the X values. So you see how you have 4, 1, 0, 1, and 4. Now, what we're going to do here is we're going to say that it's 0, 1, and 4. All of my X values. What is the solution to this inequality? If I were to solve this, I subtract 4 ninths x, subtract 4 ninths x, I get 2 is greater than or equal to. Now, 1 minus 4 ninths is the same as saying 9 ninths minus 4 ninths. 9 ninths is 1. I get 5 ninths. So 1 minus 4 ninths is 5 ninths x. I subtract 4, I get negative 2, 5 ninths x. Now, if you type in your calculator correctly, you can divide by 5 ninths, but I recommend multiplying both sides by the reciprocal. I should get negative 18 fifths is greater than or equal to x. And that looks like that matches with choice 1. Notice how this is pointing towards the x. It's still pointing towards my x. Number 12, it says, which expression represents the number of calories that Connor can burn on the stationary bike? Well, on the stationary bike, he's burning 5 calories per minute. If B represents the number of minutes on the stationary bike, we're doing 5 calories per minute times the number of minutes. So we're going to say 5B. Number 13, if I distribute, I get 15 48ths minus 5 6x equals 16. Now, I am going to use my calculator to help me with this. Now, if we're going to do 16 minus 15 48ths, make sure you put parentheses around your fraction. Okay, so I get 15.6875. Now again, if I divide by 5, negative 5, 6, I don't recommend this strategy, but it is what it is. So you ready? 15.6875 divided by, now I need to put this in parentheses. So I'm going to do parentheses, negative 5, divided by, you're using this button to do the fraction, it's just the division. And I get negative 18.825. This should be choice number 2. Feel free to use your calculator, but please put parentheses around your fractions. In number 14, you're talking about a number of cells that triples every hour. Anytime you see triples or doubles or multiplies by something, you can usually think of exponential growth. Both of these are linear equations, so I'm going to cross these off. These are both exponential equations, and I know that because they both have x as the exponent, or t as our variable, okay? So basically, if I put in 0 for my exponent, I have 103 to the 0. 3 to the 0 is 1, and 100 times 100, 100 times 1 is 100, okay? So my answer is choice number 2. For this recursive relationship, you want to find how many blocks there will be when n is 7. So I plug in 7 for n, a to the 6th plus 7. A sub 6 plus 7. Well, in the first term, we had 1 block. In the second term, we had 3 blocks. Third term, we had 6. Fourth term, we had 10. The fifth one, we're going to have, you see how we're adding 2, we're adding 3, we're adding 4, we're adding 5. We should have 15 blocks. Then we're going to add 6. We should have 21. So in the sixth set of blocks, we're going to have 21 blocks. And we should be adding 7 to it. So we should be getting 28.